Hello, we're talking about particular Christmas songs and Christmas carols that mean something to us. And I've today chosen one which you may not know. It's quite a relatively recent one. It's written by the wonderful hymn writing combination of Keith and Kristen Getty, but also Stuart Townend. They wrote In Christ Alone together as well, which is probably their best known song, but they've produced lots of wonderful songs. I love them for the poetry, for the music, and for the sense that you get of the big picture of who God is and who we are. And so what I've chosen today is called Joy Has Dawned Upon the World, and it gives the story of the message of Christianity, really. It's the story of the gospel, and I love the poetry of it. When they're discussing Christ in the manger, they talk about the fact that this is the incarnate God, the fact that God, who was there at the beginning as part of creation, has now become a part of his creation, and not just any old part of his creation, but also an incredibly fragile and small piece of his creation as he's born in that stable. And the way that they write the words for that come across to me as being so fresh. So they use the words, hands that set each star in place, talking about Christ and his role in creation, shape the earth in darkness, cling now to a mother's breast, vulnerable and helpless. I think just in those four lines, it really gives a sense of how vulnerable Christ became in order to come to us. And then probably my favourite verse is verse 3, which talks about the scene of the shepherd. And again, it's set in the wider context of who Jesus is. And one of his titles is the Lamb of God, meaning that he was the perfect sacrifice for our sins. And so they've expressed this beautifully, I think. Shepherds bow before the Lamb, gazing at the glory. It's a wonderful couplet there. But to think of the shepherds looking at the Lamb of God, and they bow before the Lamb. Not something that shepherds would normally do, of course. And then it goes on in the same verse to talk a bit about the gifts that were given of gold, frankincense and myrrh. And the songwriters again point out that this prophesied something about him. So it talks, gifts of men from distant lands prophesy the story. Gold, a king is born today. Gold being a symbol of wealth and the kind of thing you would give a newborn king. Incense, God is with us. Incense used in the temple for worship and speaks of a proximity and intimacy with God. Myrrh, his death will make a way. Myrrh was a really unusual gift to give to a baby. As a baby shower gift, it's a weird one, but because myrrh was used in the preparation of dead bodies, and yet myrrh was given to him because it points to his death being really significant. And so to read that in a less fragmented way, gifts of men from distant lands prophesy the story. Gold, the king is born today. Incense, God is with us. Myrrh, his death will make a way, and by his blood he'll win us. I'm going to try and link this song, because it's still in copyright unlike some of the others that we're using, into at least a link so you can click and listen to this wonderful song for yourself. I think there's so much in it, it's so rich. And I particularly like the version that I'm going to flag up either in the comments or by some clever link that I haven't worked out yet. The version by the Gettys that goes into transists? That's not the word, is it? Transitions, this is so slick, isn't it? Transitions into a beautiful rendition of Angels from the Realms of Glory. It's just beautifully done, I think. And so to finish with some words that finish this Christmas song, Joy Has Dawned. What a saviour, what a friend, what a glorious mystery. Once a babe in Bethlehem, now the Lord of History. You may not know this song, but do check it out. It's just wonderful and already one of my favourite Christmas carols.